And now your host, National Public Radio science correspondent, Ira Flatow.
Welcome again to Newton's Apple, the program that answers your questions about science, medicine, nature, the world around us. So let's get right to that first question. And this time, it comes from a singer, Brent Ellis. Now, Brent normally sings on the stage of the Metropolitan Opera, but he gave us a special private concert.
Figaro, 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 Figaro.
Hi, I'm Brent Ellis of the Metropolitan Opera. I think I sound good everywhere, but I especially sound good in the shower. Can you tell me why?
Good question. Now, you and I may not sound that good, but I think you'll have to admit that for some reason, everybody sounds better singing in the shower, right? Now, why is that? Here to explain is Dr. George Bissinger from East Carolina University in Greenville, North Carolina. Welcome to the program, Dr. Bissinger.
Pleasure to be here, Ira.
Why is it that everybody thinks they sound so much better in the shower?
Well, it's something called resonance. That's what gives you rattles in your car, and that's what makes a bell ring, and that's what allows a singer to break a wine glass.
Resonance. That must
that's
mean
right.
it's something to do with the sound then, right?
That's right. Now, I'm going to give you a little plastic tube here. I want you to wave that around in the air.
Nice sound.
Good sound. Good sound. Now, that sound wave is like water waves or ripples on a pond. And the distance from crest to crest is what we call the wavelength. Now, this is a model for a sound wave.
That's the wavelength of the sound coming out of that tube?
Out of that tube, that's right. Now, blow on this constable's whistle.
Much higher frequency.
That's right. Shorter
wavelength. Shorter wavelength. Higher frequency, shorter wavelength.
That's exactly
right.
Good
lesson there.
Now, if you wanted to call your dog, you couldn't hear it, and I couldn't hear it, but your dog could, and it would be a wavelength like that.
That tiny little short wavelength. There's a very, very high frequency.
Exactly
there, right?
Now, let's call your boat. Get this organ pipe out here.
Oh, this organ pipe, blowing this end?
Blowing that end, yeah.
Ooh. Very low sound.
Yeah, nice low sound.
That means the wavelength must be very long on that pipe, right?
That's exactly right. Wavelength just like that one shown back there.
That's very big.
Yeah.
What does all this have to do, though, with the way we sound in the bathtub when we take a shower?
Well, it's important you get your wavelengths right. So let's walk over here to our mechanical shower, and we'll show you what we mean.
This is a mechanical equivalent, then, huh?
That's right, at least in a physicist's mind. Now, this is one side of the shower. There's the other side. Mm-hmm. We use the string as the air inside the shower. So when you disturb the string, it's just like singing.
Right.
Okay? Now, at the other end of there, that string, we have a vibrator. This is like the person singing.
All right.
And I can change the frequency of the sound by adjusting this dial right here.
So when you turn it up like that, you get a higher frequency.
That's right. And the higher I go, the higher the frequency.
Doesn't seem to be doing very much. It's vibrating a little.
That's right. It's wiggling a little, but it's not doing much. But if I hit this frequency...
Well, suddenly it's getting wider in the middle. Oh, look at that. What happened? Why did it suddenly pop up like that?
Okay, now that happened because I hit the resonant frequency. And that's where the waves are going back and forth. Instead of just going away, they reinforce one another in the center. That's a loud sound. Soft sound.
Now, why at the resonant frequency did it pop up like that? I mean, what is there about the wave that you showed us the wavelengths before? What's happening?
Okay, we have just exactly the right wavelength to go between the walls of the shower from here to here. I can do the same thing.
There it goes again.
At this frequency.
Look at that. And you can fool around with it and fine-tune it to get it up. Look at that. So then the wavelength just fits right into the shower stall.
That's exactly
And that's what
right.
you call resonance.
And that's right. That's the only case in where you get it. You go up a little bit higher, dies off.
Yeah.
Go a little bit higher, comes back again.
Now you've got three of them.
That's right.
And that's a my great demonstration.
Okay, now let's turn that down.
So much for the mechanical demonstration of the analogy of the bathtub shower stall. Mm-hmm. Can you actually hear it if you would go inside a shower stall?
Sure can. Let's take a shower.
I'm not getting wet inside the shower.
Oh, no, we're going to do a dry run here. You just grab this guy right here.
All right.
Now, that's just a loudspeaker I've got hooked up to a signal generator here. I'm going to switch on the sound, and I've adjusted it so... Okay. Now, just pop that in and listen to the sound and see if anything different happens when you stick it in.
Doesn't sound very much different here.
Okay,
it sounds about the same.
The reason for that is I've changed the frequency so the wavelength is different than the dimensions of that shower. What I'm going to do is adjust it to the resonant frequency.
You turn it lower so the wavelength's going to get longer.
That's right, and it now will fit exactly in the shower. Can you even hear a little bit of a rattle there?
truly amazing. It's almost vibrating the walls of the shower stall here.
That's right.
But my voice is not this low. I wish it were, but it is not this low when I sing in the shower.
Well, that's okay. You saw back here on the string, which was our analog for the air, mm-hmm. that there's a lot of different resonant frequencies, and that's the way it is inside a shower stall.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't have to hit just one pitch. All you have to do is hit some of those resonant
right.
frequencies.
Right. And now, why do we sound good? Is it just because we sound louder? Is that really what we perceive as sounding better, why we like to sing in the shower?
Pretty much, as far as I know. All you do when you sing a certain note and it sounds good to you, you're saying, it's a full, strong voice, and it's the resonances building up those tones.
And it's the loudness that makes us good singing in the shower.
That's right. It sounds better, sounds bigger, fuller, sounds like you're Caruso or something like that.
Speaking of Caruso, I mean, they say he was able to break a wine glass by singing. We've seen the commercial where the singer is able to break a wine glass. Is it really possible by using resonance to break that wine glass?
Certainly is. Come on over here. I've got a demonstration.
Ah, I see.
Okay.
We couldn't afford Ella Fitzgerald, in the commercial.
Right, but this is about the same shape as Caruso used to be. Okay, now here we have a wine glass out here in front.
Mm-hmm.
That's a good quality wine glass.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, loudspeaker inside this box, and then a device to produce sounds at different frequencies.
Mm-hmm.
What I'm going to do is find the resonant frequencies, because that's where you really make it vibrate. And if you vibrate it hard enough, it'll shake it apart. To find those resonant frequencies, I'm going to tap it.
That's the sound you want to make come out of the speaker.
That's right. Now, if I get that sound and I make that vibrate enough, it's going to break apart.
All right. In that case, I'm standing back. I want to be out of the way of the flying glass.
Okay. Here it goes.
What an explosion. It's glass all over the place.
Yeah.
I didn't expect it to really blow apart quite like that. It happens like that all the time.
Oh, that was impressive.
All right. Why don't we look at that in slow motion replay and we can see what actually happened in the glass. Why don't you describe what's going on here?
Okay. Now, what we see here is the vibrations building up, it fractures, it shatters, and sprays apart.
My goodness, it just literally blows itself up from the inside, from the sound that's coming out of our little box over here, right?
At the resonant frequency, just like we did there in the shower.
Well, Ella Fitzgerald, I think you got a little competition here. Thank you very much, Dr. Bissinger, for that shattering experience. We'll be right back.